everybody, welcome back to Zone Clubs at Home.
In the next 4 weeks, we're going to be following a Christmas theme.
Hopefully by now you've received your packs, which has got everything in that you need for these following weeks.
And similar to last time, we're going to be doing songs and games, activities and stories. But this time, like you say, it's all about Christmas. Well, it's time for our game, and this week it's a quiz. And what I want you to do is I'm going to read through some questions, and in your bag you need to find your two cards that have got a tick on and a cross. And what I want you to do is, as we go through the questions, I'd like you to put up whether you think you've got it right, whether you think the question is right or wrong, whether it's true or false. And Kate's going to answer the questions as well. And I'll let you know each time what the answer is, and you can keep a record of how many you get right and see if you can beat Kate. Okay, so first question. Christmas Day is on the 25th of December. Is that tick or cross, right or wrong? That's right, it's right, it is the 25th of December. Some people don't celebrate Christmas until the end of January. Tick or cross? True or false?
I don't know, but I guess maybe some people around the world might not.
Well, it's actually false, Kate. So if you put false, you've got it right. If you put the cross, you've got it right. Christmas is all about receiving presents. Yes or no? Yeah, Kate's got it right. So if you've put your cross up, you get a point for that one. Jesus was born in a stable. True or false? Kate's gone for a tick there. What have you got at home? Well, in fact, it is actually false. It is a cross. The Bible doesn't say where he was born, only that it wasn't at the inn. So that's a bit of a trick one, really. An angel told some shepherds to visit Jesus. Yes or no? True or false?
Did you say shepherds told angels?
No, an angel told some shepherds to visit Jesus. That's right. It is true or tick. Three kings visited Jesus. Have a little bit of a think about that one at home. Well, Kate's got that one right. We're not sure how many, and they weren't kings. They were wise men or seers. Eight, a star appeared the night Jesus was born. True or false? Yes or no? A star appeared. If you've got the same as Kate, you've got it right. So that's another mark for you. You should only give presents to people that you like. That's, yeah, false. Everybody gets Christmas Day as a holiday. So that's around the world. Everyone gets Christmas Day as a holiday. That's our last question, number 10. And Kate's got it right. So if you've got it the same as Kate, you get another mark. And if you'd like to add up all your marks and let us know how many you got right, and then we can add that to your individual point score. Send it in by email and see how many you've got right with our Christmas quiz.
Come and join the celebration. It's a very special day. Come and share our jubilation. There's a new king born today. worship by a star.
Here I am again. It's Christmas time and it's exciting. And we've got to do some more craft. Oh, isn't it good? Now you might be wondering why us chickens know all about Christmas. Well, we love telling stories. We love telling about what great Aunt Mabel did. She fell off the water board. She flew up there but couldn't get down. But over generations, from generations and generations, we tell what happened and what we saw. And we had chickens. We were chickens, free-range chickens, strutting around when Jesus was born. And we were there. Well, I wasn't, but some of my, what you call, ancestors were there. And we were a bit sad because we're not mentioned much in the nativity story, but we're going to put that right at the same time as we're going to do some crafts. Now then, we're going to start with an angel. I've got an angel here. I don't know if you can see her. I'm going to hold her up for you. There you are, there's an angel. Now, I've got an auntie. She's called Michelle. You might, it's a funny name, but when she hatched out of her egg, the first word she turned round and said, she says, "Hey up, that's Michelle there." And that's what her mum and dad called her, Michelle, because that was her first word she said. But she likes knitting, and she's knitted me this angel. So, shall we make an angel? Now then, in your bag, you've got something like this, haven't you? And you've got this. Now, oh, I forgot my glue again. I keep forgetting my glue. Hey, I forgot my glue. I've got to do a bit of running around. I don't like doing that very much. So with the glue, glue this bit here, look like that. Ooh, put a lot on there. And then there's a little dot on here, and you put that point on the dot so it's going down, and it just, whoopsie daisy, make sure it's straight. Oh, I've got a bit wobbly. There we are. And just glue it down like that. There we are. That's good, isn't it? There. I think what we'll do now, we're going to do a bit of decorating. Oh, I've got one here I prepared earlier. I'm just going to show you that one in a minute so you can see what we're aiming to do. Can you see it? Yeah? This is what we're going to, this is what we're doing. So I'm going to get my yellow pen because this is her wings. I'm going to do a bit of yellow pen there and a bit round there. Quite know what angels look like, but I think they were dazzling. Oh, and I know from the story I've heard, a chicken, a free-range chicken, was running around, and Mary was feeding it. when this angel appeared before her. Oh, I've never seen anything like it. It took their breath away. They were amazed at what... Oh, can't quite remember what was said, but I'm sure you humans, you people, have got that written down so that you will remember and you will learn that on what was said. There we are, look. That's a bit prettier, isn't it? Made it, coloured it a bit yellow. Now then, oh, the angel hasn't got a face. We better do a face. So we need our scissors, and you've got a pink circle. So we've got to cut round the pink circle. Sometimes it's easier to move the paper, hold the scissors in one place and move the paper around, slowly closing the scissors. And that makes it a bit easier. My face has gone a bit wonky though, but it doesn't matter. And then we've got this gold piece of paper. Can you see that? With a like an arc. And if you look on the other side, there's a shape, and we're going to cut that out. Oh, it's got a slit in it as well, because that goes over the head. Right. So we're going to put the head. Whoopie daisy, got my fingers mixed up. Put the head in the slot like that, so it holds it all in place. Okay, I think we might need a bit of glue there, don't you? Otherwise it's going to drop off. And that would be a bit sad, wouldn't it? Put a bit of glue on, and I'm going to put it in again. Whoopsie daisy. My fingers are a bit... not so good. There we are. Push it in. And then we're going to glue all of that. So put some glue around on the back of all of them. So we can put it in on top of the point, just a little bit overlapping. There we are, like that, okay? So it's just overlapping a bit. See? Whee. Ooh, that's good, isn't it? It goes backwards and forwards. Now we need some eyes and a mouth. Happy. The story goes that the chicken was so, that the angel was so bright, it had to go and hide, and was a bit frightened as well. So he went and hid because it was so bright. We're going to just put, you see these stars, we've got a strip of stars, haven't we? And we're going to put these on because, oh, it just makes it look brighter than ever, doesn't it? Mary must have been, I bet she was a bit frightened, don't you, to begin with. But I'm sure the angel said something nice to her. Here we are. We'll just put some stars on. Oh, I've lost that one, it's got stuck. There we are, look. How's that? All right. So that's the angel who came to Mary right at the beginning. Okay, we'll see you again later. Bye.
Well, welcome to our Christmas story. And today in our story, we have two characters. The first is Mary. And Mary is visited by this little character, the angel Gabriel. So behind me, we have a very bare looking Christmas tree. And week by week, we are going to decorate that tree with the characters in our story. So Kate's going to come along and she's going to decorate with our first two characters. And while she's doing that, I'd like you to get your book out of your pack It begins in Bethlehem by Bob Hartman. And we are going to read the first story together. It's called A Woman Called Mary. A woman called Mary was doing her chores when an angel arrived, but not through the doors. He simply appeared and she dropped to the floor. "Hello, Mary," he said. "God is with you."
"God is with me?" she wondered. "But what does that mean? What's this all about? Is it some kind of dream?" The angel smiled. "Don't be scared. Please don't scream. God is happy with you and will bless you."
God knocks down the proud and lifts up the meek and does mighty things for those who are weak and blesses the ones whose service he seeks. So sing out his praise. He's amazing.
"You'll soon have a baby," the angel went on. "A quite special baby called Jesus, God's son. The heir of King David, he'll sit on his throne and his kingdom will last forever."
"But how?" Mary asked. "I don't understand. I'm engaged to be wed, but he's not yet my man." "Trust God," said the angel. "He's got it all planned. His spirit will come upon you." God knocks down the proud and lifts up the meek and does mighty things for those who are weak and blesses the ones whose service he seeks. So sing out his praise. He's amazing.
"God's own holy son is the child you will bear." "Impossible." "No, your cousin would swear that she can't have a baby. The proof is right there. She's expecting a son. Go and see her. There's nothing that God cannot do, don't you see?" "Well then," Mary nodded, "please do that for me. This impossible thing, his servant I'll be." Then the angel waved bye and he left her.
Let's just pray together. Father God, thank you for the amazing story we've just read. Thank you that you came to this lady, Mary, and you did this amazing thing through Jesus, your son, coming to us. Help us as we learn about this Christmas to take it in again. In your name, amen.
Amen.
Well, this month's challenge is what's in the gift. Each week, I'm going to give you three clues and you need to listen carefully and try and guess by the three clues what is in the gift. If you're listening at home, you can then email me the answer and any correct answers will get some points, which will be totted up for the end of term. For Kate, she's going to have to remember her answer and tell us next week to see if she's correct. So I'm going to hand you the gift, Kate. Don't squeeze it too hard. That's cheating, isn't it? Because you're not allowed to do that at home. Okay, so the first clue is a name for a type of cake or fish. Tricky one. Clue two. Appeared three times in the Christmas story. And clue three. Sang to the shepherds. Okay, so from those three clues, get your answer and email it into us for some points. And Kate, you've got an idea?
I do.
You've got an idea.
I do have an idea.
Okay, we'll see if she's right next week. Well, thank you for joining us today at Christmas Kids Zone at Home. It'd be lovely to hear a little bit back from you if you've got time to send in some of your pictures, some of your answers to your quizzes and games and things. And we look forward to seeing you again.